Support for this program is provided in part by Marquez Brothers El Mexicano Brand, Bimbo, Legacy Construction, and the Fresno Clovis Convention and Visitors Bureau.
What a beautiful night in downtown Fresno for the first ever Pacheco Classic. It is the Fuego hosting San Francisco City FC on CMAC. Hi everybody, alongside GM and owner of the Fuego, Jeremy Schultz, I'm Adrian Loveneau. Jeremy, both teams are coming off their loss last week. What does the Fuego need to do to come out and just get a win?
Yeah, you know, they had a great week of training. Last week a bit unfortunate, didn't get the result at home like they would have liked, but at the end of the day, they got to come out today and execute, play with some confidence and find a little bit more dynamics in the attacking third to get some clear chances on goal, and those are some of the things we worked on this week.
That was San Francisco's first PDL match, as their match last week was canceled due to rain in Las Vegas. Now, they had a midweek match against Wednesday against CD Aguiluchos, and they lost 3-0, giving up goals past the 80th minute. 2 days rest. What do they need to do?
Yeah, you know, sometimes those things can work in your favor. You know, I'm sure that they're glad they got a match in before the season kicked off. And, you know, giving up those late goals, maybe some fatigue or some things set in being early in the season. But I'm sure they've had a chance to break that film down, come back, and make some adjustments. And I expect to see a very good San Francisco City team tonight.
As we mentioned earlier, this is the first Pacheco Classic. Tell me a little bit about it, Jeremy.
You know, the Pacheco Clásico was kind of a brainchild from some people in the front office of Fuego. We have a women's team in the Fresno Freeze and obviously the Fuego, and San Francisco has a women's team in the Nighthawks. The two women's teams play in the WPSL, obviously the two men's teams play in the PDL, and we wanted some kind of internal rivalry to build. You know, the Northsiders, the supporters club of San Francisco City, and the Fire Squad Fresno, the supporters of the Fuego, have kind of they got a little bit of a vibe together, and so we created this cup. There's a 3-point system, so each game counts for something, and the end of all the results after July 10th, the doubleheader in San Francisco, the winner will take the cup home.
Now let's go to the starting lineups. First for the Fuego, in goal, Augustin Ray leads the Fuego. In the back line, we have Trevor Spurgeon, Sergi News, Alex Caldwell, and Juba Cipriano starting for Elliot Horde after Horde rolled his ankle earlier in practice. Blanco, Torres, Campos lead the midfield. Nogales, Medina, and Cheney up top in his first start. Now for San Francisco City FC, Manny Jimenez starts in goal. De Luna, Gold, Kelly Crow man the back line. McCabe, Watson, Murphy, along with Altamirano, Littleton, and DeMarzi. Tonight's officials for the game are Adriana Contreras. The sidelines are Tucker Schwarber, Julian Arias, and the fourth official is Bro Velasquez. Just about set to kick it off here from the Chuck. Fire Squad have their smoke bombs ready going off.
Right, Fuego fans!
Fuego will begin with possession in the first half.
Of the Pacheco Classico is at hand.
Christian Chain to give a little shout out to the Fire Squad. Appreciating their support.
I think Christian's excited to step on the field. He was ineligible because he had just come back from Armenia, and his international clearance hadn't gotten through U.S. soccer yet. So I think he's excited to step on the field back home here in Fresno.
Waiting for the referee signal to get start. And we are underway in downtown Fresno from Chancy Park. Finds Chaney. Chaney cleared by Kevin Gold. Goes out of bounds. Fuego retains it. As you mentioned, Christian Chaney did go to Armenia after the February 18th friendly here. Let's talk to me about that. What happened there?
Yeah, you know, he played well on FC Ararat Yerevan, who was in California to do a 3-game series. Liked how he played when we matched up against him, and they offered him a contract and took him back to Armenia. You know, the culture and things there were a little different, something he wasn't necessarily real comfortable with, so now he's back and playing in the PDL for us.
Blanco, at the free kick, finds Nate. Over. Session switching back and forth. Akrancho fighting for the ball. Back to Noose. Plays it back to Ray. Ray over.
Also, don't forget the best tasting El Mexicano traditional yogurt or smoothie for your
convenient breakfast on the go. Change. El Mexicano. Controls the touch. Fights off the city defenders. Milton Blanco pressuring the captain, Nick Littleton. Hard challenge. Referee awards it for Fuego.
These first 10 minutes be critical, just trying to find a rhythm. You know, the team, especially City coming off a game Wednesday night, trying to get their legs back and a little bit of possession, build some confidence. And Fuego, same thing. You know, they need to connect some passes and try to find some weaknesses in the City lines.
Campos fights off defenders, finds Cipriano. FC kicks back. Littleton on the ball. Gets fouled. Free kick. Awarded to City. Referee just keeps on talking to. Calling him back. That was Abraham Campos with the foul. Campos is a Fuego veteran. This is his fourth season with them. Played at COS in Visalia and incarcerated Word in Texas. Lining up for the free kick is Kevin Gold. Gold plays it in. Headed away by the Fuego. Now, interesting fact about San Francisco FC. They're supporter-owned. 51% are owned by supporters, 49% by other people. How important is that?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a good model, especially at this level. You see it, you know, all over the world. But you know, San Francisco, the North Siders, and I think they have another group there that are the 51% owners. I think it's great. I mean, these guys are loyal fans. They follow, you know, their team around the state, and you know, they live and die by their team. And I think it's wonderful.
Blanco over, back to Nunes. Nunes plays it back for Ray. This is Ray's second start of the season. Colwell back to Nunes. Running up, looking around. Not too much on-ball pressure by SF City. Littleton fighting off to Fuego. SC awarded the throw-in.
Couldn't ask for a better night here at Chuck Chansey Park. Got a nice little breeze. It's got probably about mid-70s right now. Last week's game, we had a torrential downpour right before the match, and this weather's just perfect.
Great night. A little bit of wind, but that doesn't affect it. It was better than rain, right?
Absolutely.
Spurgeon throws it in. Looks for Chain, just headed away. Bad for possession, looks like a handball. San Francisco will be awarded the free kick. This is the City FC's first PDL season.
Yeah, this is actually their first match, too, since the last game got canceled. So, you know, we opened up FC Tucson's inaugural campaign as well on a Cinco de Mayo where Nini Blanco scored a 50-yard goal in, like, the 89th minute. So maybe tonight Fuego have a little luck like that with a new club coming into the league.
Ball played down the line. Right there is Alex Colwell.
Colwell's a local product out of Bullard High School. Been around the training pool for a while, and this is his first year where he's become a fixture in the group.
Noose. down to Spurgeon. Spurgeon run down the line. Littleton looking to take it away. Blanco on the ball. Back to News. Kicks it over to Cipriano, the Brazilian.
And like most Brazilians, he's got one name. He goes by Juba.
Juba.
That is his nickname that everybody calls him.
Short and sweet. Let's take a look at the replay. Little foul right there. That gets up.
Nogales got kicked there. Looks like he's holding his right knee.
Ball played out by DeLuna. We have Fresno Fuego throw it. Plays the ball inside. Cuts in. Shot is just wide.
Tony Torres had a nice clean touch to split the defenders. Just hit it a little strong and skied it over the bar.
Manny Jimenez from Pittsburgh, California. San Francisco State. He transferred to San Francisco State from the City College of San Francisco. This is his first start anywhere. Goal. Keeps his head up, looking around. Looks downfield into Murphy. Just played across.
It's like Robert Kelly there had a nice touch and won the ball, had a pretty clean look at the goal, just didn't hit it well. Nice little story on one of the San Francisco City players, number 19, Dylan Murphy. He actually was a part of the Fresno Fuego in 2013 when we won the conference and made a nice run into the Western divisional playoffs. We lost in PKs to the Portland Timbers. So Dylan's back at Chuck Chancey Park, only he's in the San Francisco Gold.
It's great to see players moving all over, extending their career. Ray goes back to News.
He was certainly a critical piece for us in 2013. Him and his brother, Nick Murphy, one of our center backs, were critical in that run in 2013.
Damaris finds and it's saved by Ray. What a shot there by Altamirano.
It's an early chance for San Francisco. A little too clean of a look than I think Coach Lanigan would like, and Ray did a good job to get his fingertips on that.
City will have a corner. That will be taken by Damaris. Damarzy. He played at Missouri State. He's the captain of his golf team in high school.
Interesting fact.
This is his first start this season. Previously played for Crewe Alex in England.
Number 10, Giannis Damarzy.
Damarzy, ready to play the ball in. Silent official, holding him off. Dispute in the box. DeMarzi's corner played in, and is headed out by the Fuego.
A little confusion there between Juba and Sergi. They got to communicate and make sure we get that ball cleared. Referee makes an interesting call. I'm not sure if must come off a City attacking player there.
I guess so. Augustine Ray plays it to Colwell. Back to Ray. And back to Colwell. Well, looks downfield into the feet of Blanco. What a nice little run right here. Plays it inside. Just a little too much there for Tony Torres down the line. Tony Torres is a Selma native, and they're very proud of their Bears out there.
Selma's been a great supporter of the Fuego, and it's nice to have Tony, who comes from that community. He comes from a family of Torres boys that are very, very talented players. So hopefully there's going to be a few more in the pipeline that put the Fuego jersey on.
As you mentioned, the Fresno Fuego came into existence here, 2003.
In Fresno, the franchise was bought in 2002. The inaugural season was 2003, and it was a great season. They went on an Open Cup run, lost to the LA Galaxy at the Home Depot Center when it was called the Home Depot Center, now the StubHub Center, in the fourth round, and really set the tone for the planting the roots of this franchise.
Mm-hmm. Colwell into Campos keeps on going. Oh, just a little behind Cipriano. DeMarzi with a throw-in. Right to Littleton. The noose. To Blanco. Finds Spurgeon on the right side. This is Milton Blanco's fourth season with the Fuego. Previously played for Chivas USA.
Yeah, Milton's a community guy. You know, he's been around this community since he was a little kid. He grew up in the Roosevelt Youth Soccer program and has been a leading ambassador of the sport. Played professionally, like you said, for Chivas USA, also with the Columbus Crew, and spent a lot of time in the USL and the NASL. And it's always nice to have Milton back here home and representing the hometown club, Fuego.
Now he's looking at getting back his 2011 form as the PDL MVP that year. Scored 12 goals and led the league in assists with 14. Chaney gets the ball, but Adrian Contreras will call it back. Free kick to the Fuego. As you mentioned, Polanco is a community guy. Set to get married soon. So you wish him well on that. Played at FPU.
Yeah, Milton actually, before the Fuego came to fruition in 2002, maybe 2000, young player, 16 years old, traveled with Mexico SC, which was a local club that won the Open Cup in the amateur division back in Philadelphia. And he was a critical piece of that team at 16 years old. So Milton's got a ton of experience. He's the type of player you want in your side to help the young players and keep the good flow and tempo of the game.
Blanco plays it inside, just above Nogales. Fuego looking to regain possession, and Colwell does. City FC to Littleton. Nice on-ball pressure right there by Spurgeon. City throws it in. Takes it back. Looking downfield there for Littleton. Blanco there to clean it up for the Fuego. Now he looks downfield for Nogales. And it is saved into the hands of Jimenez. Goalkeeper Manny Jimenez broke the JC state record for the least goals scored against in season. So it's a tremendous goalkeeper talent. Littleton. Playing outside, it'll be a throw in for San Francisco. DeMarzi from Carmichael. Just hand it to Littleton. Littleton received a yellow in the US Open Cup match. In the 73rd. His free kick last week just missed in the 84th minute. Littleton throws it in. And it is saved by Ray. Noose plays it back to Ray. Ray calling his defenders forward. Looks downfield for Chaney. Chaney heads it up. Just a little out too much. Down. Two minutes. And it'll be a foul.
Chaney's going to have to keep in mind it's a 90-minute game. I know he's anxious to to get forward and do something special, but maybe trying to do too much. You know, he needs to connect with his supporting midfield and try and combine something. He keeps turning right into those two center backs.
And Chaney can play everywhere on this field. He was an All-American center back at Fresno City. So wherever you need him, just plug him in.
Yeah, he played a little holding midfield for us last year. He actually played on the flank against the Misioneros when we were down south and scored a goal in the first 10 minutes. So he is a very versatile player and incredible athlete. It's a yellow card
right there.
Number 18, Robert Kelly.
Kelly having a dispute there. Contreras holding it down.
early yellow card inside the first 16 minutes there. Looks like it was off the ball a bit.
Great to see the referee taking control early. Ray lining up for the free kick. Played for the Real Salt Lake U18 Academy in the MLS. Ray downfield. Cheney. Gets it down. Cut back. Spurgeon down the line. Spurgeon crosses it in. Just too much. Blanco's there. His shot too high.
First touch got in underneath him a little bit, bounced up. So that's a hard ball to hit. He tried his best to get over the top of it, but tough technical positioning there.
We want to thank all the Northsiders in San Francisco City FC for watching the game. They're at the Keyser Pub.
Got a few of them that made the trip down south. Handful of them that came. I see them out there in Section 130. Got a few flags and a few of their supporters here. That's great.
And it's great to see that, especially with the Fire Squad as well, how much soccer has grown, not only in America, but in Fresno and around California.
Yeah, we definitely live in a thriving soccer market here in Central California, and Fuego's been able to be on that platform here to be the team that this community, you know, is represented by, and we take great pride in our football here.
Now, there was a study done where Fresno was ranked the number 16 soccer market in the nation, ahead of places like Portland, Philadelphia, and countless others. How important is that for the future?
I think it's great. You know, I mean, the data speaks volumes. And we host Liga MX games. We've had MLS games here, and those games are always sell out. You know, we're considered, fourth division in this country, and we've been number one in attendance in our respective league in the PDL. Last year we averaged 3,900 fans, and it just keeps growing. I think it's great for this country, all over the country. It's exploding with passion for soccer, and we're feeling that here in this community.
Ball caught inside the sponsorship boards, but they retrieve for Spurgeon. Spurgeon plays it in. Looking to cut inside, cross the ball in. Tony Torres. Just a little too much. Not talking about that growth here in Fresno. What is the ultimate goal for you guys?
You know, I mean, ultimately we want to have our own venue. This is a beautiful park. Chuck Chancey Park's beautiful, but it is a baseball stadium, you know. And for us to continue this progressive growth, we need a smaller venue that's a little more intimate for the game, and so that our fans can be closer. And those are things that we hope to accomplish in the future. You know, with those things comes the potential to have a USL club here in this community. I think we have a community that can support that. So we'll see. Time will tell.
Cheney was brought there bound by Cameron Crowe right there. Cheney's looking for a card. Looks like he might get one from Contreras. Contreras just gave him a talking to. Cheney is noticeably upset.
Emotions are high. Cheney's just got to walk away from that. He's not changing anything other than a reminder that this referee is probably going to get irritated with him and quick to draw the yellow card next time he acts up. A professional, you just walk away, just stay in the game.
Now, you had a professional career as well.
It was brief. It was a brief stint. I enjoyed it. You know, I won two PDL national championships with the Central Coast Roadrunners back in 1996 and 97. The nice thing is the history of that club is now here in Fresno. That's the franchise that we were able to purchase, and you know, spent 4 years in the A-League and had a great time, you know, in its infancy stages of professional soccer in America. So really enjoyed playing the game for a living for a while, and you know, now my career is here as a general manager, and I just love everything about where this sport is going in our country.
Cipriano back to Noose. Blanco calling for the ball. Yes, it plays it inside. Just too much for Cheney. After sitting knock around, Blanco retains it. Crosses it back in. Right down there for Nogales. little too much. As you mentioned, Central Valley Coast Run, or Central Coast Red Runners, have their roots here now. So what happened there? Was it bought out? What was it?
Yeah, I mean, the Roadrunners made a nice run in the PDL. Like I said, we won two PDL national championships, and then they continued to hold the franchise rights for a while. Larry Smith was the owner of the team, and, you know, he had a son that finished his collegiate career, and, you know, I think he was just ready to kind of pass it on to the next person, and, you know, we were fortunate enough to be there and ready to grab the franchise and get those rights.
Kelly brought up Nogales. Take a look at that one more time. You just see right there, not a yellow, just a little talking to. Motions high here at the Chancy Park. Gorgeous evening in downtown Fresno.
I think both teams know how critical these points are in the league standing. You know, Burlingame got out last weekend and got 6 points. They ended up beating Laguna FC on the road down south, and we do not want to, you know, both teams really, really see how important these 3 points are tonight.
Cipriano plays it to Blanco. Blanco taken down, and a foul will be called, and it looks like it'll be a yellow card. And a yellow card will be awarded. Looks like that is Barry McCabe getting the yellow here in the 23rd minute. Now McCabe has been all over. Played for Seacoast United here in the PDL. He is from Galway, Ireland. Played for the University College of Dublin in the Ayr City League. Ball played in. Chaney to Blanco, and it'll be a foul on Chaney.
It's not a bad idea by Fuego there. I mean, Chaney's 6'3", big kid, can get up in the air, and you know, last week against Burlingame, we were playing balls in the air against two big center backs. Tonight they have a target up top that makes sense to put some balls in the air and see if he can get on the end of them.
Chaney's another veteran going all over the place. Played in Mexico, and he's looking to continue his soccer career. He looks like a great talent.
He really is. He's a local talent from Bullard High School. Young kid, born in 94, and you know, he's got all the tools, and hopefully he continues to be disciplined and focused and maximizes the opportunities that are going to be presented to him.
Cole has it, and his shot's just too much.
That's a great strike by the 10 there.
Jonas,
yes, hits Dembars. That well on the volley with his left foot and just smacked the crossbar.
Nice chance right there. Nothing you can do there, the goalkeeper, right?
Man, I tell you what, he hit that well, and Fuego's fortunate not to be picking that ball up out of the back of their net.
After 25th minute right now, 25 minutes have passed. What do you see right now?
I think Fuego in particular needs to get the ball on the floor and start connecting some passes. They, you know, seem to give the ball away a little too easy, and that's just not going to work in their favor if they want to execute and find some chances on the goal. So City seems to have a little bit more of the run of play, and we'll see how this goes the next 15 minutes here.
Blanco picks it up, finds towards the line. Ball played in to Chain. Back to Spurgeon. Spurgeon crosses it in. A little too much. Picked up there by Robert Kelly. Free kick for the Fuego. Excuse me, throw it. Chaney. Littleton takes possession. Nice little back heel right there. Watson down the line. Finds McKay. Back to Crow, to Kelly. Fuego, take it back. Down the line. Throw him for the Fuego.
interested in seeing Medina tonight. He's a new player with the Fuego out of Lindsay, California, just south of here. He's been playing in Boston at Boston College and had a great season. So interested in seeing what he brings to the table, maybe a little bit of energy and excitement, hopefully produce some goals.
He had 11 goals and 11 assists out there with the Eagles.
It's great stats.
Ball played back to News. It's a cool one. Fine, Medina. To Torres. Torres to Chaney. Chaney holding the defender off. Down the line. Spurgeon crosses it in. Too much power there.
It's much better from Fuego, though, and for me that starts with Chaney playing with his back to the goal, not trying to turn into those center backs and take a chance on losing the ball. Finds Abraham, they change the point of attack and get a good service in. That's much better from the Fuego.
Kelly, ready to throw it in for City. Looks downfield for Littleton, but it's headed away. Kelly. To McCabe. McCabe, no foul call. Nice little shot, but it is into the arms of Manny Jimenez. Throw right to DeLuna. DeLuna dribbling upfield. Finds McCabe. Possession back to Blanco. Foul call, Blanco. Take the free kick. Now SF City has some competition now, as the Deltas will be playing the NASL in 2017. Two soccer teams up there in the market now. Do you think that affects it?
No, you know what I mean? I think it's two different spaces. You know, NASL is considered Division II soccer in our country, and
Cipriano brought down.
And they're full-fledged, you know, professional. And so this, the PDL is an amateur league. And
Chaney, call back. As Campos is down. Free kick awarded. It's like about 18 yards.
Visit facebook.com/USLPDL.
No guard, just talking to.
It's a dangerous spot for City here.
Jimenez lining up his boys out there. Wall being set up. Nogales and Blanco. Interesting to see who plays this ball right here.
And Agalas has got the left, you know, he's got a strong left foot. Blanco with the right. Depends on
free kick. Hits the wall. Cyber Chaney. To News. Chaney. Oh. What a save there by Jimenez.
Goalkeeper did well to stay in front of that there.
Now looking to counter is SF City. Too much right there on the ball. Back to Ray. What a chance there.
Chaney was inside the six with a pretty clean look at the goal there, but Jimenez came out and did well with it.
To Blanco. Blanco down the left side. Dribbling around. Looks to cross it in, but Robert Kelly hits it out of bounds. Yeah, corner for the Fuego.
Game's getting a little more life here.
Let's take a look at that save one more time. Look at that, just right there. What a chance. Jimenez is just right place, right time. Great look at the fire squad right there. As Blanco lines up for the corner. Plays it in. Just to, and he scores!
Oh.
What a goal! But Alex Colwell, Fuego take the 1-0 lead.
Our center back comes up and has a clean look at the goal on the backside, and didn't look like he was too confident with it going in, but saw it sneak in that near post, and What a good good situation for Fuego. Find themselves up 1-0.
This ball right here, Blanco beautifully played in. Over Chaney. Colwell just heads it in just enough. Right there, might have taken a deflection.
Looks like it just came off Cameron Crow there. He was leaning to his right and couldn't recover and get back to his left to cover that near post, and it snuck in. Fuego are up 1-0 in the 31st.
Huge, right, Jeff? Huge goal right there.
That's just what the Fuego needed. It's what these fans here in Fresno needed, and hopefully it gives this game some life.
And the Fuego look to get another one as they come up here. Blanco plays it to Spurgeon. Spurgeon wisely plays it back to Ray. Finds the goal scorer right there, Colwell. Colwell to Noose. Noose looks downfield with his head up. No city pressure. Finds Medina. City take over. McCabe to Littleton. Watson on the ball. Plays it back to DeLuna. He's going to look in back to Littleton. Littleton. Blanco back. Possession for the Fuego. Fuego looking to get back and get that counterattacking goal. Medina. Into Blanco. Blanco looking to Cipriano. But it's just outside as it's taken by Jonas DeMarzio. Littleton battling for possession right there. Gets it. And the referee will say it is a throw-in for City.
Sometimes your most vulnerable time as a team is right after you score a goal, and so hopefully the Fuego back line can stay organized and take care of the pressure that San Francisco City is going to put at them here, trying to respond to that goal against.
Kelly throws it in. Two Fuego defenders there pressuring. Another City throw-in.
Last time he threw it right in the inside the six-yard box. It's playing in the baseball field. It's not a very wide field, so we'll see. This is almost like a corner kick with the long throw-in.
Littleton hands it back there to Kelly. Kelly looking in that box, trying to pick someone out. Kelly's long throw-in. Just short for Littleton. City maintains possession, but it's quickly taken away there by the Fuego. The City says, I'll take it back. Held off there, and the referee will say it is a goal kick. Minute. Here's Chachansey Park. Great evening for soccer.
Can't ask for better weather. Got a nice little breeze. I'm thinking it's probably about 70 right now. And we got a nice little crowd that came out tonight. There's a lot of things going on in town. But, you know, the Fuego fans, they typically show up, and that's great. It's been the backbone of what we are as a team in this community. And we got a great fan base to lean on.
Reyes' goal kick. It's maintained by the Fuego. City takes it away, but back to Fuego. Playing the Torres too much. Littleton picks it back up and is fouled. Free kick to City. Play to goal. Goal looks downfield. Not him too much on it. Fuego maintains possession. Looking downfield, looking to break.
Torres is a pacey player if he can get in behind that line.
Back and forth goes possession. Great defense there by the back line. Cipriano holding it down. And it looks like we have a player down. Blanco gets back up though. Play on. Going to be a throw in for the Fuego.
Got another
and
yellow
card right there. DeMarzi receives it. His first of the season. Interesting to see what that was for.
It was from that last play when they were there was about three players on the ground. It looks like he got in a little tough on the tackle on Milton.
I think it's right there for the kick up right there. Fico's throw in, quickly taken away by City. Watson dribbles a little too much and too far.
Stop by Easy Hall.
Midfield and defense sure working tonight for the Fuego.
Chaney did well again, just keep possession of the ball. He's kind of getting in his groove now, I think, and realizing he doesn't have to do too much. Just connecting with that supporting line behind him.
Cipriano receives the ball. To Campos, back to Blanco. Taken away by City. Well, pressure there for Nogales. Gets the Fuego back the ball. Campos dribbles upfield. Finds Spurgeon. Back to Campos.
This is better by Fuego. Keeping possession, being patient.
Cipriano back to Colo. Ray plays it in Noose. Sergi Noose out of Barcelona, Spain. Played at Fresno Pacific. Big FC Barcelona fan.
Unlucky for Nogales there. Fuego had good possession, just misstepped. Yeah, Noose came into us a couple years ago as a 17-year-old young player, just trained really, and came back eager to represent this club. Has done a fabulous job. Played at Fresno Pacific last year, and it looks like he'll be going over to the University of Virginia.
Fuego looking to score one more time, but it's just played out for a throw-in. With halftime coming up, how big is it to score here?
Yeah, I mean, the number one thing for Fuego right now is not to get caught on a counter and give up something silly. They need to stay organized, stay compact defensively, and not give up a silly goal. Minimize their mistakes and understand that, you know, one goal will win you this game. At the end of the day, they want to get forward, and they want to create more chances and put some more points on the board. But defensively, they got to stay organized.
Chaney plays it back. Crossed in. San Francisco City takes it back. As we mentioned, this is San Francisco City's first PDL season. Their goal is to be in the top flight of soccer by 2020. So they're very eager, like the Fresno Fuego, to get as far as possible. How important is that? Not only for the PDL, but to show that the growth of teams and just get soccer all over.
Yeah, I mean, for all clubs, I think you got to focus on the space that you have. And, you know, Fuego's been around in this community for 14 years, and it takes a long time to get your roots planted in a community and build the fan base and have consistency amongst your club and sustainability. And so, you know, we all have ambitious visions and dreams to get to the top level, but, you know, for Fresno Fuego, you know, we know our space, and we want to be the best that we can be in the PDL. And hopefully, if we're good at what we do there, then there'll be opportunity to move up.
Ball right into the hands of Jimenez. Jimenez looking downfield. Now with the PDL, players can be paid, but usually they're all university kids.
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple instances. Kitsap, for one, was a PDL pro, which they were grandfathered in. Now with the PDL, everything is back to amateur except for those clubs that were grandfathered in. And, you know, we want to use college players. We want to use this as a platform for them to get exposure and move on to the next level. I mean, the theme of the PDL is Path to Pro, and we want to be a part of that. That platform, we've always had 70-75% local players, and we feel that we run a good organization and give those kids an opportunity to excel. And one of the things we take great pride in is we've had over 50 players that have come through our program to sign, they've moved on to sign professional contracts. As long as we're in the PDL, we hope we can continue to help these players do just that.
That's a great thing, seeing everyone move on to just seeing Cheney getting that chance in Armenia and just seeing Blanco coming back to the community from the MLS. It's great seeing that.
Yeah, I mean, that's what we're here for. You know, I mean, at the end of the day, we want to win national championships, no doubt. I mean, anytime you step on the field, you want to win. You play to win. But at the same time, the development component is a critical piece in our business model. In my personal opinion, part of that development is creating an attitude to win, an environment to win, giving these players the resources, what it takes to win. And so, you know, a lot of things are based around results at this level, but at the same time, you know, our job is to get these guys opportunity to sign professional contracts and pursue their dreams.
Cipriano dribbles down, takes a shot, but not enough on it. Just for Jimenez, easy little save right there.
Knowing Juba, he would like to have that one back because he can knock the paint off the ball. And I can guarantee he was his mouth was salivating when he had that kind of space outside the 18.
Now Juba was a co-MVP for the West Hills Golden Eagles out there. So he definitely can play. He could definitely have that shot out there in the left foot. We'll play her down right now.
Nogales down. He's claiming cleats up.
Take a look one more time. Fouled right there by De Luna. Gets back up. Looks to be a free kick.
He's getting up gingerly. It looked like he took a hip to the ribs there, and he keeps holding the right arm, saying cleats up, so not sure exactly what happened there, but I'm sure he'll shake it off and be all right.
Adriano Contreras talking to both players there.
The emotions have been pretty high in this first 44 minutes. The players have not refrained from talking to the official. Hopefully both coaches will remind them that she is in charge and to be cautious, especially City. I think they got three yellow cards now, and they definitely don't want to double yellow and go down a man.
City maintains possession. Looks downfield, Littleton. Dribbles upfield. Keeps Noose off. Played back to Murphy. Down to Watson. Watson plays it back in. And it's chipped and it is saved by Ray.
Ray makes a great save there. He's in 1v1. He had his hands up. He was leaning a bit to the left, but he got his hand up and stopped that. Strong hands. That's great.
That was a great chance with Altamirano right there. That bounce right there, I'm sure, scared everyone from Ray.
You know, early in the year, Ray's a new player into our Fuego program. That's the way you build confidence with your back four.
Ball played in for Cheney. Cheney takes it away. Holds off the defender. Takes the hit, and it'll be a yellow. No. Murphy reached to her pocket.
2 minutes, stoppage time.
Looks like Cheney was in a headlock right there.
Yeah, they got tangled up a bit there. Cheney's wise to just step over the player and get out of there. It's a great chance for, and Cheney just got a yellow card. was just going to say how he did well to walk away from it, but
oh, we have a red. A red card right there. Looks like that is Dylan Murphy.
Opposing teams are not going to want to come to Chuck Chancey Park. 2 weeks in a row, red cards against the opponents. This time giving Fuego a man-up opportunity for 45 minutes. So I'm sure that something was said. She was quick to draw the red, but...
right there to DeMarzi. The captain is sent off. She's done a great job tonight maintaining it.
Certainly, Fuego's got a good look at the goal. Couldn't ask for a better spot. You're right in the middle of the pitch. About 23, 24 yards out.
Dangerous spot. Blanco looking to step up and take it, but not so fast as Nogales is there. Terrified as a decoy, maybe.
We'll see. Got a left footer and a right footer. Which way they go?
Both dangerous from the spot. A little confusion right there in the wall by SF City. Watson holds it up. Blanco.
Goal!
Inside. What a free kick. Goal for the Fuego. 2-0.
That is a fabulous set piece. Milton picked a spot and without a doubt, knocked it in the corner. And the boys have a nice little dance.
Fire squad going crazy out there. Smoke blowing. What a free kick. I mean, if you take another look at it, look at that.
It's a fabulous hit. He looks into that top corner, picks his spot, puts it out of the reach of Jimenez. Great goal.
And the captain gives the Fuego the 2-0 lead just before halftime.
Certainly should lift the spirit of the boys as they enter the halftime break here.
Fabulous.
Got Fresno Fire Department in the alley behind Fire Squad waving their Fuego flags. Gotta love that.
Love the support here. Great community atmosphere. We appreciate you watching here on CMF, but come out to a game. Come check it out. It's a great atmosphere. Plenty of games, too, next week. Thursday and Saturday against the Las Vegas Mobsters. Contreras blows her whistle, and it is halftime. The Fuego have a 2-0 lead. Off of goals by Cola and a beautiful free kick right there before halftime by Blanco.
Yeah, it was really a textbook goal there by Milton. Hopefully, kids at home, if you're watching, very composed, didn't try to crush it, overhit it. He just he picked his spot, placed it, and what a great goal. It reminds me of his 2011 PDL MVP run. He scored a number of those goals where he had a great look and just placed him in the corner.
He might be 32, but he still has it.
Tell you what, it's I'm happy that Milton has a Fuego jersey on again and representing this community.
Early on, it looked like the Fuego had trouble keeping possession, but they fixed that up easily, quickly.
Yeah, you know, the last 10, 15 minutes, I think they played much better. They just started playing with more patience and realizing that, you know, they don't have to get forward every time. And when they did that, they were able to maintain possession, keep the ball from side to side, get their center backs involved, really stretch the lines of San Francisco City to create gaps to get forward. And when they started doing that, they exposed that back line, and good things happen, whether it's a foul or getting to the end line and making, you know, getting caught, crosses cut back. I think it definitely changed the tempo of the game.
At halftime, the Fuego lead 2-0, and we'll be right back after these messages.
From Liberia, West Africa. came to the States when I was about 6 years of age due to Civil War. Family moved to the East Coast, and then my father joined us in New York, and we made our way to Fresno, California, IA, and that's where my family's been. We've been here ever since, so. Well, Fire Squad was basically started in December of 2014. What I was called in to do was to really just be kind of like the liaison that brings people together. I know a few people in town, and Jordan said, hey, you know, if anybody's gonna make people feel at home, it's gonna be you. And I thought of another friend to get involved in Fire Squad. Her name's Nairi. And between herself and myself, you know, it was just our duty just to make sure that people just felt at home. I don't know if there's any typical match day. I mean, for us, match day begins, you know, games are typically on Saturday. So I'll get to the park at 4 with the rest of the group of that's involved from Fire Squad, and we all have different delegations that we have. So I kind of bring the energy and just that voice. So I want to be the last one in type of deal, just making sure everybody's in place. And you know, we had an idea of just doing smoke bombs for the games, and that really works. So, you know, we'll have smoke bombs going into the event, to the game, and drums, and just creating that energy, you know, getting in there and just making sure that it continues. And that's what my goal is, just making sure that energy continues. So there hasn't been a group like us downtown, right? Or even in the valley for that matter. There are clubs throughout the world that have supporters groups, and those supporters groups are known. You know, when they are walking in the street, you're a part of X, Y, and Z club, right? For us, it was creating that group to where people say, hey, you're a part of something that's positive, first and foremost, something that's fun. And in creating that positivity and uniqueness in that it's something that hasn't been here in the valley, and just it draws people from all walks of life. I mean, I have friends that are coming from Sanger, friends that have come all the way from LA just because they're former, they're transplants, right? And they see stuff, right, online, and like, hey, I want to check that out. So it draws people downtown, and that's what we need, is just a positive draw to downtown. And, you know, it's around sports that, you know, we run Fire Squad, right? And the Fuego and the Freeze. We want everyone. You know, I mean, it'd be amazing. You know, the stadium holds 15,000 people, I think they say or estimate. It'd be amazing if we had 15,000 people in that stadium making noise and singing and just having a good time, all in the name of local sport. And it's something that can be done once people just realize that it is attainable and it is fun. So, I mean, once you experience your first game, once you see a smoke bomb or you see confetti or streamers, there's something to that, right? And that's what we're trying to create here. We're trying to create that sense of, yes, you can be a part of this. It starts with you, you know, and we'll get there.
My house will be a bully-free zone.
My tournament will be a bully-free zone.
My Instagram will be a bully-free zone.
My school will be the bully-free zone.
My team will be a bully-free zone.
I will not be a bully.
I will help the bully.
I will stand up to bullying.
Join us, take the pledge.
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 Tehachapi Park is a bully-free zone. Take the pledge at FresnoFuego.com.
CMAC empowers the members of the community to tell their story by offering them the opportunity to learn how to use video equipment, how to use the facilities we have to offer. CMAC is an organization that is devoted to allowing people to tell their stories. 99% of those organizations and individuals that have stories to tell have never been able to do it because they couldn't afford to. Now they can. CMAC empowers members of the community by offering them the opportunity to learn how to use all the wonderful equipment that we have available for them. And then once they've learned, using that equipment to create their own content.
The great thing about once someone has filmed and edited their video is that it is aired via Comcast and other channels. And this gives Arte Americas the opportunity to connect with outlying communities, people who may not have a chance to discover us any other way.
To see your something that you've actually produced on a channel is fun for the first time, especially if you spent a lot of time with it. And it does take time to learn the programs.
Because you hear it all the time as a producer, we can help get you out there. But this is the real deal. There is no gimmicks. There are no type of games that they play. You produce the content. You follow the guidelines, it will air to the community and be an inspiration to the community.
CMAC is here to provide that venue. And it provides that venue to every aspect of the community, every part of the community. No one else does it that way. No one else offers that. The importance of CMAC's members cannot be overstated. CMAC is its members. We've trained hundreds of people. And we've already seen hundreds of stories, and the results of those stories are being felt in numerous ways.
I got involved with CMAC because a friend of mine already belonged, and we volunteered to film a fashion show, and because there were good classes for CMAC, they ran us all through all the instruments and equipment that we were going to be using. I felt good about the experience, and I felt really confident, and actually it was really a lot of fun too.
And the training is simple. You know, when I did it, I think I took 7 classes, and at the end of 7 classes I got a certificate and I started recording things. Anytime I've had questions, the staff here has been great, and they've given me the opportunity to try different things with whatever content I'm producing.
When I got around other members seeing that they had different visions than I had, but that we could all partner together. It was just like a giant gumbo or a giant buffet of different ideas, different creators, but all with one purpose: to create quality content.
You can't do it all. You can't be the man in front and behind the camera for every production. CMAC needs volunteers because it's a community-based organization, and the more volunteers you have, the higher quality of production you can achieve in your program.
People can contribute to CMAC by just participating and coming up with your own clever ideas and coming to the functions, coming to the events.
I feel great about being able to send volunteers and people who are just connected with Arte Americas over to CMAC so they can develop their own art form. I think you'd be hard-pressed to find another organization providing this level of resources here to the Valley, to anybody who is interested, motivated, and wants to sign up. It's incredible. We love having them across the street, and they really are adding to what the Central Valley is providing.
CMAC is an outlet for anyone who wants to get their message or their skills or their artwork or whatever it is out into the community. It's a professional atmosphere where you can get the help that you need to be able to produce your program, and as a result, Fresno gets so much more to see and find out about.
I mean, when I see the smiles when people come through on orientation, or when they're hanging out in class, or seeing their projects being on the big screen in the lobby or on TV, that's magic. I mean, it's one thing to hope to do something, but it's another thing to help people fulfill and be that servant in the community. And that's what CMAC is. CMAC serves to help fulfill people's dreams.
Can you help me with this?
My new dad teaches me all kinds of stuff.
Sure.
He helps me with homework.
That would be 3.6795.
Thanks.
Yep.
He helps me with my decision making.
I wouldn't use this one.
You guys are having fun.
And he's even teaching me how to drive.
And that's why cars have bumpers.
I'm learning so much.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of kids in foster care will take you just as you are.
Thank you.
Ted's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
Everywhere that we go, he makes people laugh and makes people smile, and I feel like I have that quality.
He's the one who always takes me fishing.
I watch golf with him. And
I watch him cook, because when I grow up, I want to be a cook too.
We have the same faces like this.
Dad is the one, when you fall, that picks you up.
That unconditional sense of presence and reassurance is really what makes him my father.
So, I just moved in with his family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
Welcome back to Jachancy Park here in downtown Fresno. Fuego out to a 2-0 lead over San Francisco City FC. First half. Possession all over the place. Red card. Had everything in it.
Yeah, it did have a little bit of everything. You know, it took a little bit of time. It took about 15, 20 minutes for the teams to settle in a bit and get those nerves out. And I think at the end of the day, it was a good 45 minutes. Coach Lanigan should be pleased with the boys. It's the first goals for Fuego in the 2016 season. And, you know, these fans are ready to party, and this helps.
Now we're ready to check out some highlights here, brought to you by CMAC, our beautiful television partner here. Cipriano gets fouled right there, passes it right there for Nogales. Physical early on. This physicality is brought back. I mean, yellow cards last week for in the U.S. Open Cup matchup for City FC.
The referee's definitely been tested here. The egos and attitudes of the players were testing the boundaries, and she took control, that's for sure.
Chaney maintained position the whole time, all over the place, as well as Blanco. I mean, you're constantly calling their names, and that's what you want as if you're Coach Sean Lanigan. Two veterans stepping up.
Here's the goal off the corner kick. Milton serves in a good ball, and Colwell finds himself on the back post and gets his head on it, and it deflects off the defender there and into the back of the net.
That was in the 31st minute. Going to take a 1-0 lead. There's a yellow card awarded.
Definitely a physical first 45 minutes. And Contreras, the referee, was tested on having to pull out some cards.
Now you have the promotion coming up soon, the yellow red card giveaway. Might need to be today.
Yeah, it's next Saturday. Yeah, we got a yellow and a red card promotion presented by Little Caesars. It's going to be a great night.
Great save right there by Ray. Chaney getting physical there.
This is what set up the goal here. Boom.
Beautiful. Second half. Physicality is probably going to continue. See who's going to come on as subs, and seems FC City can come back.
It looks like, just looking out at the pitch now, Felipe Oliveira, one of our Brazilian players, is coming on to play on the right-hand side. You know, it's a long 45 minutes, and some people say 2-0 is the most dangerous score in soccer. So Fuego's got to come out, stay defensively organized, and make sure they don't make any mistakes and give up a silly goal. And if they do that, they should have this game a good handle on this game. I mean, they're playing them up a man again. For the second time in 2 weeks, and hopefully they dictate the pace and the flow of the game.
Jordan Hughes looks to be he subbed in there for City FC as well. San Francisco ready to kick the ball off to begin the second half. Contreras looking at the clock. And we're about underway here in the second half. Action. Before I go with the 2-0 lead.
Fuego did well there to win the ball back early and see if they can keep some possession and be patient and open up some lines here with the San Francisco City back line.
News to Colwell. Back to Chaney.
to Noose. Noose Vice Virgin. Ball is taken away there by San Francisco City. Down the line they go. As does George Pickus.
Spurgeon did well to recover there and win the ball back. And the physicality returns. An early foul.
Right there as he's brought down. And
tough spot to go down on the turf, just from the natural to the sport turf there. You want to stay on the natural if you can, but Trevor goes down and probably skins his knee up a bit.
Now, I've seen matches here before at Chancey Park. Liga MX, MLS, doesn't matter. They will cover that patch-up with real grass. Now, talk about how come that doesn't happen in these games.
Yeah, I mean, we share this time of the season with the AAA Fresno Grizzlies. Economically, it doesn't make sense to pull out the pitcher's mound and buy all the natural sod and, cover all the infield. In February and March, it's feasible because of the fact that we can use that multiple times for games. But in this environment, we have to be able to turn the field quickly between baseball and soccer. Last night, there was a Fresno Grizzlies baseball game. We had a packed house, 12,800 fans here to watch our baseball team, and tonight we're playing soccer.
Fresno Fogo off to an amazing start here. We also want to mention the Grizzlies. They're the defending AAA national champions. And they're off to a great start, too,
yeah,
in their season.
They're struggling a bit this year, but, last year, 2015, they really brought the city to life with that national championship, something we needed. And, we're just so proud of our baseball team, and as was the community, and hopefully they continue to get things on the right track and find their way into playoff baseball again.
The Astros affiliation definitely helping there. Now, has that been brought up before, having a pro team come in here into the PDL and play you guys?
We've talked about it a little bit, but the timing just hasn't been right. You know, we've talked to some good potential partners, and maybe somewhere along the line those things will happen. But right now, it's all about Fresno. It's all about the Fuego, and, we're moving forward. Soccer's trending in a positive way, and we've got a very good community vibe. You know, our slogan is For City and Club. And when we put that Fuego jersey on, we're representing this Central California region and specifically Fresno.
Fuego maintaining possession right there by Campos. Back to Colba. Noose. Blanco back to Noose. Blanco looking around. Back to the first goal scorer right there, Colwell.
Colwell had a smile on his face in the locker room there when a center back can get forward and put a ball in the back of the net, get themselves on the stat sheet.
Yeah, something on Kristen Chaney, right?
And they're friends. They went to the same high school, so sure there'll be some tweet battles on that.
Chaney's looking to get back that goal right tonight. And the fire squad out there ready to erupt for another goal. Ball played in. Spurgeon to Chaney with the bicycle kick there, just wide of the net.
A bit ambitious by Chaney there. I think he's 22, 25 yards out trying the bike. I guess you can get away with that when it's 2-0.
Exactly. He manages, lines up. Ready to send this ball to the midfield. Minutes is kicked downfield. Brought back by the Fuego. Spurgeon. Ball just didn't have enough right there for Blanco. City back with possession. Played back.
Fuego won it.
Chaney inside the box. Looks to shoot. Is Torres over. To Felipe Oliveira. Ball's brought into the box, taken outside. At the touchline. What a move there.
Chaney, that's a fabulous goal. Alvaro Nogales in the corner beats his guy in a beautiful 1v1 and just spoon feeds
Tony Torres.
Yeah, our Selma native. What a fabulous goal.
Selma is going crazy tonight. Tony Torres finds the back of the net. Fuego take a 3-0 lead.
Alvaro Nogales footwork in the corner, kind of baits the defender in towards the corner flag. Turns quickly, it looks like, potentially put it through his legs, found himself with some space and gives Tony a great pass. Clean look at the goal, and Torres finishes it.
Fire squad going crazy as they're coming into your screen.
Fire department's got the sirens on. The firefighters are up with their Fuego flags. I love seeing this.
Great community involvement. What does City FC got to do now?
You know, they can't change the game in one pass or one moment. You know, they gotta get their composure now. They're down 3 goals. Not easy recovery, but at the end of the day, there's, you know, 40 minutes of soccer left, and they gotta take a deep breath and just try to chip away a little bit at a time and see if they can get some penetration in that back line of the Fuego defenders.
This isn't a very great start, important hopefully for a victory here for the Fuego. But for City, how demoralizing is this? I mean, last in the Open Cup, down 3-0 here, down 3-0. How do you build off of this as a team?
They got in behind here.
They cross it in, just past Littleton. Fuego maintain possession.
A little confusion there in the Fuego back four.
City takes it back. Noose is there to clean it up and slow it down. But not before pressure right there by George Pragris.
Yeah, you know, I mean, City can't, they're not going to be able to. Yeah, it looks like we can get a replay on the goal. That'd be fabulous.
Beautiful touch right there. That was Tony Torres.
Right after Nogales beat the defender there, looked up and found Tony.
Tony right there to open his PDL bank account right there. First goal of the season.
Yeah, I mean, City's got to keep their confidence. It's early in the year. This is their first PDL game. So at the end of the day, you know, they can't get too concerned. I mean, obviously, they got to fix their deficiencies, and I know that they will, and they'll continue to be a good team.
They're backed by great supporters up there in San Francisco.
Torres does well there, serves a great ball, just nobody got on the end of it.
No foul call, referee says get up. Fuego, maintain possession.
I think Fuego kind of smells blood right now. It's they see that they're acting as a prey and can smell the blood and got some life and a little pep in their step to get after City. I think they're excited about scoring some goals here at home in Chuck Chancey Park and enjoy the emotion of Fire Squad, and they seem to be pushing and trying to put City to bed.
Now Las Vegas will come into town next week for a Thursday and Saturday matchup. Look to carry their momentum. But not so fast. San Francisco City looks to mount a comeback here. But first, they need to get possession. As the Fuego maintain it. If you're Coach Lanigan, what's one thing you take away right now?
You got to see how your players react to a 3-goal lead. I mean, you don't want to take too much risk now. You know, the game should be in hand, and you know, you certainly don't want to. You know, if you're a player, you don't want your players flying into challenges now and, you know, taking a chance on injury. You certainly want to make sure that the emotions stay under control. You don't need yellow cards. You don't need red cards. And this is a good opportunity for him to kind of evaluate his players, the attitude, the character, and see how they react to a 3-goal lead.
Going to be a corner kick right here for the Fuego. Milton Blanco teeing it up. Blanco looking for any Fuego in the box. Short corner to Nogales. Nogales is fit. And it scores!
Wow.
goal for the Fuego as they take a 4-0 lead.
Yeah, I think the confidence of City is really down. Nogales receives a ball on the top of the 18 and has absolutely no pressure on him. Takes a touch, is able to look up and just put the ball in the back of the net. Kind of bent it a little bit, and the keeper was just stuck in mud, didn't even move.
Nogales had a beautiful assist earlier, and now he has his goal. His first goal of the season. Smoke bombs on smoke bombs on smoke bombs out there for the Fire Squad. Great scene here at Chancy Park.
This certainly helps Fresno in the Pacheco Classico as obviously they can walk away with 6 points at home, and that could turn in the second leg in San Francisco. But the goal differential is the first tiebreaker, so putting all the goals away certainly helps.
Yeah, that's right. The Fresno Freeze did win earlier tonight.
Yeah, they won 3-1 against the Nighthawks, and it was their home opener tonight. And I'm sure Coach Tim Carroll is probably already watching film and breaking things down, preparing for Thursday night against Primero de Mayo out of Sacramento.
Great coach right there, Coach Carroll. Ball played back. Blanco finds Nunes. Sergi back to Blanco. Blanco looks downfield.
It's a great ball from Blanco on the switch.
Just too much on that ball for as it is out of bounds, and the Fuego will have to throw in. Juba takes it. Nogales battling. Chain takes a nice little touch right there. Saved by Jimenez. Nogales has been all over the place. I think he's been the difference this half.
Yeah, he really has. He's gotten his bearings. He's connected well, combined with his midfield. And found Chaney's feet, and they're playing well together. That's a good sign for the future of the Fuego.
You hear the Fresno Fuego Stadium chant going back and forth.
Got Fresno on one side of the stadium and Fuego on the other. It's what you like to see from your home crowd.
Great atmosphere at the Chuck tonight. Felipe brought down by second base, but he gets back up. Even though the field's not up to dimensions as you would like, it's still great playing surface out here.
Yeah, you know, you make the best of your environment. I think Fuego's done a great job of, you know, finding good partners in the community, as you can see with the field boards and squaring the field off. Obviously, you play left to right field, and playing in a baseball stadium, the fans can't touch and feel and, you know, necessarily get into the game right next to the field of play, but you create a good environment. Fire Squad's helped with creating this atmosphere of energy, and it certainly filters into the rest of the fans, and I think we got a great thing going here at Chuck Chancy Park.
Blanco line up for another corner kick. Played outside. Chaney, header's just wide.
Chaney's a big target at 6'3". Can jump through the roof and got up on it, but just couldn't direct it on the goal.
Fresno's cheer getting there, practicing on corners. Jimenez looks down. Header from Spurgeon to San Francisco City. Oliveira down the wings. Oliveira downfield, looks to cross it in. He does. It's tipped away right there by Jimenez. Just wide. Nice little right of play right there.
It's a good chance. Felipe got in behind there. Milton plays him a good ball. Takes a touch and gets it across the face of the goal just out of Chaney's reach, and Alvaro couldn't get on the end of it, but a good chance from Fuego.
Oliveri was the Alaska Airlines Player of the Week for the Fuego last week.
Fuego's finding a lot of space right now, being a man up, and you know, City's struggling a bit to keep the ball, and Fuego's relentless getting forward. I have a feeling there's gonna be some more goals in this game.
Chaney has it taken away right there, and it is a goal.
There it is. Chaney did a lot of work there to win that ball back. Took a touch, turned, and banged it in the corner.
Nice little celebration right there from Christian Chaney. 5-0 Fuego here in the 61st minute.
Little element of surprise there. He won it back and took a quick shot. Here's the replay on it. Gets in hard on the tackle. Is able to take a quick touch to turn and does what a striker should do and strikes it right away. Good finish.
Great turn right there. Great defense. The All-American center back at Fresno City. That definitely showed right there. Great value as a striker. Fuego sure smelling blood out there.
Yeah, it doesn't look like they're going to let off the gas pedal either. They are going to pressure and go after, get after this wounded City team.
Being a man down is obviously showing right here for SF City. On both sides of the spectrum right here, if you're a San Francisco City player, what are you thinking right now?
I think the clock's moving awfully slow for these guys right now. You know, I think they want to wash their hands and get out of here on this one and hopefully kind of stop the bleeding, if you will. But this is sports, you know. I mean, these the City boys got to show some character. They got to fight through it, and I think ultimately the coach, you know, he's trying to probably get them to be composed and stay organized. And
ball played down right there for Oliveira. Oliveira finds Chaney in the box. Chaney brings it back out. Chaney looking to dribble around. Is fouled right there by SF City. George Plakaris with the foul. Nice little move right there by Chaney, getting the ball back out. Littleton with the foul.
A little frustration there.
Several Fuego players warming up. Might have a change coming in soon. But right now it's Blanco and Oliveira on the ball. Oliveira plays it. Blanco looks to bring it back in the box. Just a little high right there for Alex Colwell. But another corner for the Fuego. Blanco has to run opposite field.
Sure he's fine with that. He's not in a huge hurry. A little relaxation. We got, you know, Fuego play again on Thursday, so Coach Lanigan looks like he's going to get some of the guys off the bench into the match. Wise move with 3 games in 7 days. Make sure he doesn't run any of his critical elements into the ground.
Blanco plays it short. Plays it back for Juba. News finds Chaney. Chaney inside the box. Shot is deflected. Oliveira looks to try to clean it up. But right there is George Plakaris. Oliveira looks to throw it in. Finds Spurgeon. Spurgeon crosses it in the box. Too high. Looks like we'll have 3 Fuego players coming on. And 1 for City. Taylor Gordon. Joe DeRosa. And it looks like Gabriel Viana.
This will be our first look at Taylor Gordon. He just got into town from University of Houston, Victoria. Has been at one or two training sessions is all, and this will be his first time in a Fuego jersey. Good to see a new player with us. Center back, which is a position that we want to create some more depth in the spine of our team, and be excited to see him play. Joao and Gabby, both players that have been around our group. Joao played with us last year in 2015. He's a nice holding midfield player out of Brazil. And Gabby gets his first PDL action. Although he's been around the group in a training environment, it's his first PDL action, another player out of Brazil.
Now Joao had two shots last week versus Berlin game. He scored in the preseason against NASL champion New York Cosmos in February in the 68th minute.
That was actually Elijah Martin who scored that goal. Yeah, Elijah's now with the Tampa Bay Rowdies MPSL team out in Florida. Felipe in that game got around the corner, was able to cut a ball back, and Elijah Martin got on the end of it. Joao actually was pushed up a line. He's typically a midfielder and played as our lone striker last week against Burlingame since Cheney's clearance didn't go through. So Joao's a versatile player, very clean on the ball. And it'll be interesting to see what he brings to the game.
Juba. In there. Tony Torres. Back to Spurge. To Noose. City maintains possession. It looks like it will be a City throw-in. City looking deep. No one home right there. Juba down the line. Hits it back for Gordon. City take over. Spurgeon plays it off his chest. And outside, it'll be a throw in for City. Armando Flores is checking in. And off goes Andy Altamirano. You gotta give it to Altamirano. Early on, has some great chances, made great runs. City's throwing. Taken away by Fresno. Blanco looking downfield. Just too much.
Milton and Taylor running into each other. Taylor's first time on the field. Him and Milton getting acclimated a bit there.
A little tangled up. Blanco back on the ball. Back to Juba. To Gordon. Finds Noose. Great passing right here by the Fuego. Maintaining possession here in the 69th minute. Ball inside the box is kicked away right there. Littleton. Too much pressure right there from Juba Cipriano. Plays it back to Ray. Ray finds Noose. To Cole. To Blanco. Oh. Nogales on the ball. Finds Juba. Blanco is down. Gingerly getting up.
That's the fear of a coach, your captain there, going down on a tough challenge there. A little late, but you got to expect it. I mean, the City guys are probably, you know, frustrated with how the game's taking place this evening. And Fuego's got to be wise and just keep the ball moving and not put themselves in a situation where they can get kicked.
Robert Kelly throws it in. A little respect right there from San Francisco City, playing, giving the ball right back to Fresno after the injury. The Rosa on the ball. Mm-hmm. Torres. Torres looks downfield. Finds Spurgeon to DeRosa. DeRosa working that line and is headed away right there for the clearance by SF City. Another corner kick for the Fresno Fuego. Wind's picking up here at the chance part. DeRosa plays it short for Blanco. Blanco back in. Torres. Shot is saved.
Wow, got a hold of that one. You could see the ball knuckling there. Keeper does well not to try to handle the ball, but just punch it out of the danger area.
Manny Jimenez's first start. Not going as planned, but made a great save here.
Joao's shot. See the ball knuckling, dipping. Keeper does well to just punch it out.
Noose to Spurgeon. Back to Noose. To Juba. Juba to Moore. Moore looks downfield. It's deflected out. Fuego will keep it. Fire squad, having a great time out there. Relaxation time now. Up 5-0 in the 72nd minute.
So much space for Fuego on the ball. Not a whole lot of pressure.
San Francisco is sitting back.
City's got to try and put pressure in packs when they can, being a man down.
Right here for San Francisco, do you just want to throw everyone up top and just go up for another goal, or you just play back and just keep it low scoring, 5-0?
Yeah, you know, that's something the coach, I'm sure, has talked to him a bit in these types of situations. But, you know, they need to do their best to keep possession of the ball. Fuego's obviously putting high pressure and continuing to be relentless. But City's got to try and keep possession and get forward in moments when they can.
City to Plankris. City will receive the throw-in. Make sure to get out to a game soon. Next game will be Thursday against the Las Vegas Mobsters. Kickoff will be at 7:30. If you can't make Thursday, come Saturday. Next Saturday, they'll be hosting again the Las Vegas Mobsters.
Yeah, we got a two-game set with the Mobsters. They're coming into California, and we had to host them twice this year, and obviously easier to do it all in one shot in the week. And they got a nice team out there. They got some players from UNLV. Actually, there's a veteran player from this community, Robert Garcia, who graduated from UNLV, that plays for them. Nice attacking player, has good pace. Went to Hoover High School here locally, so I expect them to be good. I expect them to be dangerous, and I'm excited to see how the game goes on Thursday.
Also want to thank the great crew here for CMAC. Doing great work.
CMAC's really elevated the exposure for the Fuego and live streaming and broadcasting these games here locally. They do a great job with the students they work with providing this resource to our community.
A little dispute going on. Adriana handles it. Juba on the ball. We're going to take this free kick. You keep your gas foot on the pedal right here?
I think Fuego's taking it off a little bit, but they're still looking to score if they get in the attacking third. Obviously, these set pieces are things that Coach Lanigan wants to see how his team executes, so. Although after saying that, they just reset. So
Spurgeon on the ball now. San Francisco's defense right there. But it's quickly taken back. DeRosa. Into Blanco. Spurgeon. One-on-one. Finds it. And it's offsides. Offsides call right there on the Fuego.
It's good combination play. Players are moving off the ball. It's what you want to see if you're Fresno Fuego. It's unfortunate, got in behind the line too soon, but still positive, bright soccer for Fuego.
Firefighters little. They're ready to celebrate already for a goal. But hey, 5-0's enough to celebrate, right?
Yeah, anytime you can put 5 goals in at home, got to be excited.
Rosa looking around, his cross finds him.
Felipe does well, first touch, getting inside, tries to slot Tony Torres, who's making a diagonal run, just gets underneath him a bit.
City plays it in. City making their run on the left side inside. Drilling around is George Plikaris. Looks around. City looking to create a chance here. Try to get back a goal right here. Cross played in, is deflected, and it's cleared out by the Fuego. Tony Torres puts it down. Nice little dribble move out. Blanco looking downfield and finds Nogales down the line. Nogales looking to put it in front, and it's just not enough.
Looking for a run on that back post. He plays a good ball, just nobody to get on the end of it. Looks like Gabby cuts inside, goes towards the near post.
Great run right here by Nogales. So close.
Maybe he was just trying to pick out that far post and take a little glory for himself. Nothing wrong with that, I guess, when it's 5-0. Got to be selfish a little bit. You get inside the box. That's what good goal scorers do, and it's why they're rewarded with stats.
Almost had his second goal of the night right there. What a night for him.
Nogales has played well. He's certainly helped the team out, helped the group produce some points tonight. And you know, if you're the coach, that's what you want to see from your tandem up front. Not even a tandem, really. They play with three. He's been on the left flank, and he's produced. He's done well.
He has. He scored 15. In 15 games, he scored 9 goals for Fresno Pacific. So, I mean, he's definitely one of those that can score any chance he can get.
Got Mason Gonzalez comes into the game, and Coach Lanigan makes a wise move, getting the captain, Milton Blanco, out. You know, veteran player, a little older, preserve his body for what's to come the rest of the week. Get Mason in, one of the young Fuego players that has a lot of energy that'll buzz around the field.
San Francisco City will receive a corner kick here. Littleton lining up. Littleton's hit is in, and it is a goal.
City catches Fuego off guard. Corner kick, set piece, has got to win that first ball. City gets on the end of it and get themselves their first PDL goal.
Ball pinballed around in there. Right there to clean it up.
Give City a little hope with 12 minutes left to realize they can get in behind and put some points on the board.
So in the 79th minute, San Francisco City gets one, as it is 5-1 Fuego now.
It's not what you want to see if you're the Fuego coaching staff. You want to preserve that shutout.
Great ball played right there by Littleton as well. Giving City a chance. Juba throws it in. Littleton back on the ball. He's brought down. But nonetheless, it'll be a throw in for Fuego. City looking back downfield. Littleton making his run. But it is brought down by Armando Flores. We have a sub coming in for the Fuego. Bruno Bramati. And Matias Fernandez checking in. So rare goalkeeper swap. Got a hand to Ray. Some great saves tonight. Conceded only one goal. And Matthias is checks in. So 10 minutes and change left in this match. Throw in right here. Littleton looking to take it long. Little issue going on in the box. Armando Flores and Matias Fernandez already getting into it.
Matias, another local player out of Bullard, and getting some action here in the game is good. Gives him some experience.
Littleton's throw in from left field, right into the hands of Fernandez. And here come the Fuego looking to counter. Spurgeon. Ball's out of bounds. So we're throwing for the Fuego. Spurgeon finds Oliveira. Tony Torres gets the ball. Looking downfield. His shot is a little wide.
Finds just a little bit of space there in the middle of the park and pulls the trigger well with his left foot. Just goes wide.
Great chance there from the Selma native. Ball played downfield. Headed out. But City regains possession. Looking downfield for Littleton. Littleton plays it off his chest. Looking. Trying to find some space. City. Shot is wide. So Fernandez will take the goal kick. Fernandez. Over to Morgan. City keeping up that pressure. It's hard to do with 10 men, but they're doing it. Down goes the line. The shot is saved.
Good save by Jimenez.
City coming back. But it's quickly taken away by the Fuego. Great chance right here. Just not enough by Vayana. Gordon looking around. Finds Sergi Noose. To Tony Torres. Back to Sergi. Sergi sure had that ball all over the place. He's the core of that defense back there.
Yeah, Sergi's really come into the season and played well. And our back four kept things organized and has picked his moments to penetrate into the feet of Milton and his midfielders in the center of the park.
Sergi's a sophomore at Fresno Pacific. Fresno, Fuego have all the Fresno Pacific kids, it seems like, and it seems like San Francisco City has all the USF and San Francisco State kids.
Yeah, you know, that's the beauty of the PDL is you have to have local-based players. And, you know, that's for us, that's how this, to me, how we've built this franchise with the local players and the community getting behind, players they're familiar with. Obviously, every year we bring in players from out of the area, but you gotta have those local players. We're fortunate to have good talent here in the Central Valley.
And that's great for everyone, too. I mean, everyone has that experience playing with each other. San Francisco City had the whole back line from San Francisco, right there from San Francisco State and the University of San Francisco.
Yeah, they got two Eddie Soto's USF players in DeLuna and Gould, and I'm sure Coach Soto will be watching the match as well and evaluating his boys.
City looking to get another one, but if we have other ideas, that Spurgeon plays it on up. Rosa looking to counter. Beautiful little dribble around right there. The shot. It's not there. Jimenez ready to take the goal kick. Fire squad ready to go home. Maybe a little party left in them.
Yeah, they're not going home. I bet they're celebrating tonight over across the street at Tioga. They pregame and postgame over there, and with five goals in the bank, I think they're going to have a good time tonight.
No one's going home sad unless you're San Francisco City fans out there.
And they'll live to see another day.
Yep.
You know?
Not many, but you gotta feel for the Northsiders out there. They made the trip, though.
Yeah, and
great to see that.
That's honorable, you know, for those guys to come in and support their club on a away day. I know some of the Fire Squad are planning on going up to the city when Fresno Fuego plays against City again on the second leg up in San Francisco on July 10th. So I know they're planning to take a group up there.
And the Fire Squad is growing every single day. Last year they had about 27, 47 people march in, and compared to this season, 200 and what, 25 around there?
Yeah, they're getting close to 250. That was their goal, and I think they've probably exceeded that by now. So it's organic growth. Fire Squad is an independent supporters club. They run themselves, and it's just been an amazing addition to the atmosphere of the park. We're very grateful for those fans. They're loyal to the team, win, lose, or draw. And, you know, the boys really feel the energy that Fire Squad brings.
You see right there, great to see the youngsters involved, and it's growing.
It is. You know, we have a great community. There's a large youth community. You know, they're playing in the competitive soccer scene and the rec soccer scene. You got men's leagues, you got co-ed leagues, you got indoor. So the game's growing all over this country, and we're fortunate to be in a community that really loves the sport and is getting behind the Fresno Fuego.
Ball played back to Fernandez. To Noops. Minute. Shouldn't be too much extra stoppage time right there.
You know, San Francisco's got to be pleased that they were able to get a goal, man down on a set piece. Execution, I'm sure it's things that they've worked on in training. And, you know, for anything, if they can take something away, you know, they got a goal late. Shows their character that they weren't giving up and, you know, fighting for something out of a tough situation.
Manages ball taken away. Fuego have it. Dribble around. Tough defense by City as they look downfield, but Spurgeon heads it away. Nogales with some beautiful touches right there. Wisely plays it back to Noots.
It's nice to see Bruno Bramati out there, the left back for Fuego, back out on the field. He played. He was a fixture in the back four last year with the Fuego and was probably one of our most consistent backs. Has a great motor. He gets forward, up and down the field. Good 1v1 defending. It's good to see him get some minutes in tonight's match.
Now, if you are wondering where Jason Phillips is, he does have an event going on right now as he's attending Springtini as he's doing that. So we'll have him back next week. Jeremy, we're sad to see you leave, but you do have other duties here with the Fuego. You've done a great job over your past two games.
I appreciate it. It's been fun. I enjoy sharing my information of the Fresno Fuego and the PDL with our viewers and our fans. And, you know, it's an enjoyable piece to bring this broadcast to, you know, not only this community, but for everybody out there watching the game. We appreciate them taking interest in the Fresno Fuego and the PDL. It's a great platform for players to move on to professional soccer, and I think it's going to continue to grow.
CMAC does a wonderful job, and nonetheless here, great evening for soccer. They did a great broadcast. It's great to see the whole community come together. Fuego may be looking for one more. Played right to Jimenez. Stoppage time. Players ready. And it is it. Adriana blows her whistle. And the final score is the Fuego 5, San Francisco City 1. Great result here for the Fuegos. They get back 3 points after losing 3 against the Berlin game.
Yeah, it certainly helps kind of set the tone for the table. And, you know, hopefully gives the boys some confidence to come out Thursday and build off the momentum. Obviously, they're going to watch some film and see some of the things that they did well and executed tonight and work on those things. And also, if there's some things that Coach Lanigan sees that they need to work on, fix those things as they go against a tough Las Vegas Mobsters team on Thursday.
See the Fuego saluting the Fire Squad.
Yeah, the Fire Squad, great group of fans. We're happy to, we're lucky to have them behind us.
Who's your game MVP tonight?
You know, I think Alvaro Nogales is worthy of something like that. I'm interested to see, you know, who the staff picks here, but. Yeah, there's a number of players that did well. Chaney came into the game. I think he was a little anxious to do something in the moment when he first came in, but he calmed down, had patience, found his supporting midfield cast, and really improved throughout the course of the game. So I think we have some highlights to share with everybody here.
It sure was a great night for soccer here in downtown Fresno.
Yeah, you can see early the physicality came back into play, and
Chaney brought down. Nonetheless, we're going to remind you, Thursday will be the next broadcast here as the Fuego take on the Las Vegas Mobsters, as well as Saturday against the Mobsters. Physicality early on. Fuego did what they needed to do tonight. You have to be proud of your Sean Lanigan.
Yeah, he's got to be happy with the boys. I mean, when you produce 5 goals, it's certainly a good thing you can walk away from and smile. And I'm sure Fire Squad and players and everybody will enjoy a pint across the street in celebration and start focusing on Thursday night.
It's sure going to be a good one. 7:30 kickoff for that match if you make it. If not, we'll have the broadcast here for CMAP. For Jeremy Schultz, I'm Adrian Loveno. Good night from downtown Fresno as we leave with some highlights.